Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Kunal Patel, and today in this video we are going to learn how you can apply the various functions, or you can say operations, on the elements, to the elements, right? So let's take one example that apply some function to multiple elements in an array. So I have created one matrix over here. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I am creating one function, okay, and then that particular function I'm going to apply on each and every element of the array, right? So here I'm going to take one lambda function. I'm going to create one lambda function, right? So for that lambda keyword you need to write, and what I'm doing, I am adding the 10 to each and every element, right? So what this function will do, this function will add 10 to each and every element, right? So now we have just created the function. Now how you can use that function? So for that you can create the vectorized function. Okay, so what is the job of this vectorized function? That it converts the function into the function, right? So that can apply to all the elements in an array or the particular slice of an array, right? So how you can create it? So I'm going to create vectorized function is equals to np dot vectorize, and here we need to pass the function. So as I told you that it creates the function to the function, function into the function, right? So I'm just passing the a over here, that is my function name, okay? Or let's, for the simplicity, take add, right, as a function, so you can understand in a better way. So I have created one vectorized function, okay? Now how I can apply that function to all the elements to the matrix, right? So what I can do, I want to apply this particular function. Sorry, I need to again run it. Okay, now I need to apply this function. So v function, on which array or matrix I want to apply. So I'm just taking the matrix, okay? And now if you execute, then you can see that this particular add function apply on this each and every elements, right? So 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 and 19, right? So this way you can apply this particular function with the use of this vectorized function, okay? Right, now let's take one another example. That in this example I'm finding the maximum and minimum value, okay? So I'm going to take the same matrices over here, okay, right? But before that, let me discuss one another important point, then how you can, as in my previous video I have explained the broadcasting, right? So how you can make this particular task very easy in a one line using broadcasting. So I just need to do that. I just need to add matrix plus 10, right? And if I execute, then you can see with the use of broadcasting, you can achieve this particular task in a one line, right? So this is the power of broadcasting. So if you want to learn more about broadcasting, then please check out my session number 6, okay? Broadcasting in NumPy video, okay? Now let's find the maximum and minimum values. So how you can find the maximum and minimum value with the use of this, right? So first of all, you need to create one matrix, okay? Now if I want to find the maximum value, then I just need to write np dot max into bracket, from where I want to find. So from matrix I want to find, very easy, one line code, right? So it will give me the maximum number from the particular matrix. And suppose if I want to find the minimum, right, then I just need to write max.min and from which, so matrix, and if I execute, then you can see it is displaying the value, right? So minimum value is 1. Are we clear with this? Okay, so this way you can find the maximum and minimum value. Okay, now suppose sometimes if you want to know the maximum and minimum value in an array, or you can say subset of an array, okay, right? So how you can achieve this with the use of max and min function, right? So for this, we need to go for the axis parameter. Okay, so how this axis parameter will work, so let me execute the code. So np.max, okay, from matrix I want to find, but here I'm going to take x is equals to 0. So what it will do, it will find the maximum element in each column, right? So it will find maximum element in each column, right? So let's execute this code so you can understand. Oh, 7, 8, and 9. So from first column, what is the maximum? 7. From second column, what is the maximum? 8. From third column, what is the maximum? 9, right? So if you want to find the maximum number column wise, then you just need to use axis parameter and you just need to set the axis equal to 0. Similarly, if you want to find the maximum element in each row, okay, so what you need to do, you just need to go for axis is equals to 1. And if you execute the code, then you will get, right? So in a row number 1, 3 is maximum. In row number 2, 6 is maximum. And in a row number 3, 9 is maximum, right? So here you can also find the maximum and minimum elements row wise and column wise, right? So this is very simple and I hope you like this video, right? So please subscribe to my channel for more interesting functions and operations which we apply on each and every element of the array, right? Okay, thank you.